Buenaventura here at Ventura County, and it's 67 miles away from our home. It's still raining, and they only opened the church during mass time, and now the mass is already over, so they close it. And it's a grace that I was able to get in, and I was just inside for 5 minutes and prayed and silence for 5 minutes. Parang drive through rin. Thank you. And it's the first time, even if we were here like when Andres and Andrea was in fourth grade, they were not able to go inside the church, but now it's my fault, so my first time to get inside. Thank you. It's exactly, what time is it? 9:40, and we are here at Santa Ines Mission, and this is the 19th of the 21st, 21 missions of California missions. And it's been like, it's 30 minutes away or 30 miles away from Santa Barbara Mission. And it was dedicated in 1804. And it was named after Saint Agnes. So this is Santa Ines. And the church is closed. So we'll just offer our prayers just in front of the entrance. Now we are entering La Purísima. Mission La Purísima. So here we are at the La Purísima Mission, and it is 50 miles from Santa Barbara, and it is considered to be the best mission in terms of architecture. It has 37 rooms, which they use for weaving, for working, for farming, what else, and all the other livelihoods that Father Sierra was able to introduce to the people, to the early, to the natives, to the Native Americans. It was founded in 1787. And the 37 rooms or cuartel, they call them cuartel. Show them that over there. And there are 37 rooms there. And they use them for their livelihood, like candle making and for weaving. So those are their offices and work of place. And this is inside the church of La Purísima. I'm here at San Luis Obispo de Tolosa. It was built in 1772. And this is the garden. And I'll go to the church, inside the church later. And nowadays, they also use this for
before COVID, like for the gathering and receptions, wedding receptions. And during springtime, there are a lot of grapes here, because the last time we went here, there were a lot of grapes in this small vineyard. Let me see. They have a quilt here. Good for my bakal. And this is the old mission church. Mission San Gabriel was founded in 1797 by Father Junipero Sierra. And as you can see, that this is the only mission that has no church bell next to it. But the church bell is maybe the one that side. It's all inside, but I need to find it right now. And that bell, it weighs 2,000 pounds. So let us go and pray. The church is closed today. So we just pray in one area. Giant cactus. Where's the church bell? Let me find it. And most of the missions, one of their scenery, architectural design, they will always have like a fountain.
San Miguel Archangel Mission. These are the church bells, which are separated from the church. So maybe because they're too heavy, so they serve as the entrance before the church. We are on our way to San Antonio de Padua Mission, or Mission San Antonio de Padua. And it's
continue on US 101 North for 10 miles.
40 minutes or 40 miles.
San Antonio to Padua 1771 may be closed by the time you arrive. Destination is on the left.
Good evening, everyone. So now we are ready at San Antonio de Padua. And this church, this mission church, was built in 1771. It is located in a very long grassland and a lot of oak trees. And as you can see, there are no houses. I don't know where it is. There's no community. There's no neighborhood. Okay, so Soledad, which is also around 40 miles to 50 miles away from San Antonio de Padua. It's okay. Of water. That's why farming is really very, very productive here. And also taking care of cattle, livestock. It was founded October 9, 1791 and restored October 9, 1955. flowers, the roses, the lemons, a lot of lemons. It's nice in here. Oh, they have a lot of statues. I like this one. Oh, beautiful. But it's still closed. So, maybe they really prepared this part of the chapel if in case it's closed, so people can just pray over here. Because they have this. Statues and the cross, a simple altar, and the roses face now. It's nice, Andrea. Look at the scenery there. So beautiful, huh? Look at the mountains and my prophet Elijah in the mountains praying. And look at the bushes. See? We are on our way to Monterey, to Mount Carmel. So there is, that is where Mission Nuestra Señora de Soledad is. And then see, it lives by its name, Solitude. There at 10:12 in the morning, so it's a 56 minutes trip for less than 50 miles. Okay, see you there. This is the second mission, the San Carlos Borromeo de Carmelo, and this is actually the favorite mission of Saint Father Sierra. And above the entrance, part of its architectural there's a star after the entrance. And then just like what I told you earlier in the previous missions, so most of the missions they have their fountain always on the side of the entrance. And also here they it is 150 miles from San Francisco, and it is against the sea and the mountains. And the remains of Father Sierra are also in this mission. he was buried in this chapel. We are now at the courtyard of Mission Carmel, and as you can see, that's the bell, and the church is in that side. And as you can see, all the barracks are here, like in a square shape, and those barracks actually where the soldiers' rooms were, and also the priests and all their workers. And in this courtyard, as you can see, they have a lot of citrus and also olive trees. And at the back, they have some herbs too. So that's also part of their livelihood, I think. And that's cool. And again, there's another fountain. And I just knew from the tourist guide that most of the missions, they have fountains. It's because during the Spanish time, they use this. The reason why it's circular, because they use them for washing their clothes. And now eventually it becomes like a scenery. So that's the purpose of it, to wash their clothes. Okay. And there's a small vineyard there. And some herbs.
And what's this?
Nuts! Now let's find out where Father Sierra is buried.
Okay.
And also, since this is Father Sierra's favorite mission, this is also and he was the president of the mission. So this is actually his main headquarters of all the missions. And his office, I think, is on that side. So let's go and see his room. And they also said that in his room, it was just delayed because it was part of his mission, his simple life. We are leaving Carmel Mission now, and we are going to San Juan Bautista. San Juan Bautista Mission. Okay. Stay with us, and let's continue our pilgrimage. We are here now at San Juan Bautista, and this is the largest church in the missions. And this site, this church, was never been abandoned, and it is the only church that has three aisles in its architectural structure inside. Thank you. Come and let's pray together. Thank you. So we are leaving San Juan Bautista Mission now, and we are going to Santa Cruz Mission. Okay, so it will be like for 40 minutes, and it's 35 miles away from San Juan Bautista. Stay with us. Let's continue our pilgrimage. Mission Santa Cruz, I think, is the smallest church among the missions, and it was built in 1791. But because it was standing in a place during that time, it's a place where there are a lot of ex-convicts and thieves. And because of the earthquake also, so the padres, the priest, left this mission, and it was restored after some time when the community was able to rebuild itself. So this is the smallest church among the missions. Yay. And unfortunately, it's closed today, but you can just pray. So we are leaving Mission Santa Cruz, and now we're going to Mission Santa Clara. He named it in honor of Saint Clare, and after giving in its name, 3 months after naming it in honor of Saint Clare, he passed away. So 3 months after that, he died. And in 1857, Santa Clara Mission, it became a Santa Clara University. Let's go, come.
Let's come inside.
Sarado yan. Oh no, it's open.
on our way now to Mission San Jose. In about 10 minutes, we'll be there. Overlooking Yerba Buena on that side, those are the mountains. But fortunately, it's closed today. The museum is closed today. We came here 7 years ago. And we already went inside the museum and inside the church. Hey, good morning. So now we are on our way to San Francisco de Assisi Mission. It's located here at the 16th Street in downtown San Francisco. So we're almost there.
Go past this light, then at the next one, turn left.
So this is our third day of our pilgrimage, and we are here in San Francisco. This is Mission Dolores, but in 1776, it was dedicated to Saint Francis of Assisi by Saint Father Junipero Serra. And it also sits in the heart of San Francisco. And it is considered to be the oldest building in the city. And next to it is the church. School, and we're going to San Rafael.
Go past the stop sign.
So we're going to Mission San Rafael Archangel.
You want to take picture of first or what?
What?
Hey, what was the thing?
That's the
Great.
Rafael Mission is located 20 miles north of San Francisco, and this mission was concentrated on it was treated as a hospital. It was a hospital for the neophytes who were suffering from depression and sickness. And then, as you can see, the passage is also designed after the Mount Carmel Mission because of the star on top of the entrance. And it was established in 1817 by one missionary, Father Louis Hill, who also had a training in medicine. And in 1870, it was torn down because they said they used it for as a firewood. And then later on, they built this this chapel to commemorate it, and also the other church there next to it. So eventually, at the end, it became a very big mission because of its service to the people who are sick during that time. So this is our way to San Francisco Solano here at Napa Valley, Sonoma. Wow, the last mission, 21st mission here northern part of California. So this is San Francisco de Solano here at Sonoma Valley, Napa Valley of California, and it is a wine producing city. And in 1823, it was founded by Father Jose Altamira, and part of the courtyard inside, but sorry, we cannot go inside today, okay, because it's closed. But part of the courtyard is, there's a vineyard, and the famous world-class wine vineyard, which is San Sebastian Vineyard, part of the courtyard vineyard of this mission is still located to the San Sebastian Vineyard. So, and every year they have this once annual vintage festival because of their grapes, when they harvested grapes, and part of those grapes are being blessed here in at the mission. So it's a very festive event, and they always have here like free wine tasting. And I told my kids that we can do like a free wine tasting here as a celebration, but they said it's not allowed, mom, because we're not yet 18 years old. So I guess it's just me, because my husband will be driving. So what a day to celebrate. But at least this is our third day, and our fourth and fifth day will be next week. Okay, so we did it, out to the 21st mission, the last mission here, going to the north. If you will see the map, I will show you the map later on. And to go home now, it will take us from here, from Sonoma, to go to LA. It's an 8 to 9 hour drive going back home. So to my driver and my tourist guide, the love of my life, thank you. Thank you so much for this family. To my Comolians, so see you on our fourth and fifth day of pilgrimage, because in this 3-day trip we finished 16 stops, 16 missions, and the last 5 we will do them this coming days, maybe after a week, next weekend. Because they're in the south, they're closer to our place. 3 will be around San Diego, and 2 are around LA. And the other mission is only like, the San Gabriel mission is only like 15 to 20 minutes away from our house. See you there. Magandang hapon po, mga kapatid na Molians, at nandito po kami sa Mission San Fernando. It was named after Saint Ferdinand III, and it was built by Father Fermin Lacien in 1797. As you can see in this quadrangle, those buildings, the 3 buildings, actually there are 3 buildings, and they use this for their, they are called the working building and also living quarters. And the friars, they also help the Indians to how to make adobe. And after that, they were able to make these buildings, especially the rooftop. The roofs, I mean. And then, so everything is made of adobe. And after that, they were able to teach the Indians also on how to do sewing, what else, farming. And there's winery. So they also taught them how to make wine. So inside, if we can, now that we're going inside, the statue of Saint Fernando III was given by the King of Spain. And these buildings they were all turned into museums, but the parish is still there. And they celebrate baptisms and they have mass every Sunday. And when we go inside, you will also see on the walls that there are paintings made by the American Indians. And some of the materials they use in building things, and also the vestments of the friars during that time, they were all in the third building. But I think we all have those also in the Philippines. As far as I can remember, there is one at the museum at the University of the Assumption, where you can see all the old vestments and materials that was used, symbols during the celebration of the Eucharist. And these are examples of the
vending machine.
The vending machine. No, these are the pictures I'm telling you. So those are the paintings that they drew during that time, and they were able to preserve it. And as usual, there is the fountain. So all missions, I think 90% of them, they all have their fountains on the side of the church, and on the left side is the church. But we cannot go inside right now because there's a baptism going on. But they told us that we can come at 3 when they're done, so we can show you the chapel, inside the chapel, the church, I mean, and then we can say our prayers together. Thank you. Now we are at the San Gabriel Mission, which is named after San Gabriel Arcangel, and it is the fourth mission, but unfortunately it is under construction right now. Until now, people are still active in this mission, and part of their mission nowadays is concentrated also in education. So it became a school now for elementary, middle school, and high school. Okay, but the church is under construction. As you can see, one thing that's also popular, there's the fountain. Here we are now in the first mission, which is San Diego de Alcala, and it was established in It was established in 1769, July 16, 1769. They really had a hard time in Del Rey, and it is also here in San Diego, which is only 40 miles away from San Diego de Alcalá. And this mission is known to be the king of all the missions because of its architectural designs. And then, if you can see the rooms here, they have a different rooms. They said that they used those rooms for travelers during that time. And they built this beautiful garden. And as usual, we have the signature founder. And the founder of this mission is Father Lucien, who is the successor of Father Junifero Sierra. And today, they still use this, and the one who's using it are the Franciscan missionaries. And now it's still an active parish. And they also have a school on the other side. And a cemetery. San Juan Capistrano, our our last mission for this year.